Al, do you remember that feeling the first few weeks after Strictly finishes?
I know, but some people just can't let go, can they? They keep breaking into these spontaneous dances.
Yeah, others become desperate just to hang on to that mahogany glow.
Yeah, yeah. And they start thinking it's fine to wear spangly clothes every day.
Yeah, thank goodness that didn't happen to us.
Thank goodness.
It's for you.
Hello. Hello and welcome to The One Show with Matt Baker, who's
and,
now changed.
Yeah, and Alex Jones now in a different skirt. But anyway, yes, the glitter ball has been won.
So Brucey's been put back into cold storage.
But the dancing goes on with a huge Strictly tour all across the UK.
And tonight we've got 14 Strictly stars who'll be giving us an exclusive first look at their brand new dance. Hello!
Yes.
Hi guys, they're in. It's lovely to see you all, really is. This year's winner and the man who puts the strict into Strictly, it's Craig Revel Horwood and Abby Clancy. Good evening to you both.
Hello.
Good evening and congratulations.
Thank you.
To you and Ali Ash. We were so glad, weren't we?
We were.
Oh,
were yes.
Shh.
Yeah, no.
What,
yeah.
Oh,
we were rooting.
We were. But you look so shell shocked, Abby.
I was.
Are you over it now?
No, I'm still in shock, to be honest. I didn't expect it. I just took each week as it came and we ended up in the final and we won. So,
brilliant.
But to be honest, you haven't really been talking about it a lot over Christmas, have you? Because of one of the presents that you got. Come on, enlighten us.
The Strictly swear box, yeah. I think there's thousands in there now. Yeah, I'm barred from my friends and family about talking about it.
Yeah, we'll get it all out tonight.
What
I'm so
you
boring.
Think, Craig?
Well, I think so, yes. I mean, there's a lot of people to choose on. Natalie, of course, is a fantastic dancer,
God, yeah.
But it's
the
not always just about that. And you know it's a public vote in the final, and it's whoever appeals to the public as well. And plus, the story that, you know, and the journey that they go on. And, of course, you went on a massive one because you were, well, quite frankly, in the dance gutter when you began.
You said that.
Well, it's true. And then you went on to really learn, you know, how to dance properly. And it's just wonderful to see someone really fly through the series like that. Yeah. And I find that really inspirational.
Thank you. I had the best teacher, though, to be fair. He was amazing and
good patient.
And,
it was a good story. It really was. Well, tonight we are giving you the chance to judge the judge. Tonight, send your comments on Craig's one-show performance to the usual address. Yes, we'll read them out, won't we, Al?
Yes, I mean, you could tell us how engaging it's been, how entertaining, how friendly.
Just stick your foot. Can you do that with your hip? Look,
yeah.
Maybe you want to comment on these shoes.
I don't know. Look at these cowboy boots.
There you are. And maybe give him a score out of 10 at the end of the email as well.
Yeah. And the email's just crashed. It's just crashed.
That's really nasty. I'm never coming on this programme again.
Craig.
Anyway, we will read your comments out. Okay, John. We've done well, haven't we, to get all these Strictly dresses on our sofa
you
here.
Look but, gorgeous,
now,
Deborah,
you used to have a fish and chip shop.
I did,
you?
Actually. Yeah. One of my early businesses was I have fried many a fish and chip.
Are you still involved in the deep frying business?
Or? Not in the deep frying business, but actually my holiday parks, they used to have, you know, we used to have lots of fast food. It's good business. I mean, the fast food business has done really well. Even in tough times.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about the tour then, the Strictly tour, because it starts, doesn't it, a week on Friday. How have you chosen the dances and which ones have you chosen, Susanna?
We are going to be doing our Foxtrot and our Paso Doble. And I think one of the reasons that we're doing the Paso Doble is because we really loved doing it in Blackpool and it felt like a really kind of incredible moment for me and my partner, Kevin. And so that is clearly a brilliant one to then go and do in front of thousands of people, which is kind of a scary and exhilarating all at the same time.
Well, this is the thing, you've had Christmas off, haven't you? So has it been quite tricky to sort of get back into the swing of things?
We're all a bit rusty, I think. The stamina levels have definitely gone down and the waistbands have been expanded slightly.
But you're putting all this together, aren't you?
Yeah, I wrote it and I direct it. And of course, Jason Gilgenson does all the fantastic choreography. There's a whole bunch of new choreography, of course, for the audience to see. And of course, the Strictly Tour is a marvellous opportunity for people at home to come and see how the TV show is actually filmed, because we have 8 cameras, we have an overhead camera, huge, great big TV screens that you can get close up, so you're not just seeing little dots of people running about the space. And you get to see some of the wonderful performances that we've seen on the telly already and wonderful, great big group numbers.
And it extends your Strictly experience.
Yeah,
and that's a brilliant
thing. And everyone can just continue to soak up that Strictly vibe. People just can't get enough of it, can they?
Come with us.
Yes. Well, I've been there. Go on.
Now, Now, darts may not have the glitter. Slight change of glitter or grace of Strictly, but it certainly has a huge legion of fans.
Yeah, well, with the BDL World Championships in full flight, we sent Alex Arras Riley to put the fans' knowledge in the hockey.
Right, I'm going to have a go. Ready?
Yeah, go on, have a throw. Straight down.
Watch yourselves, girls. You love darts, don't you?
I'm a big fan. Yeah.
Who'd have thought it? Anyway, we are joined by two of the Strictly men from last series and also Nicky Byrne from the year before because Nicky's taking part in the tour.
Yes.
Welcome
on. For you making a comeback, I tell you. We've just very quickly had some comments on you so far.
Oh, here we go.
A televisual disaster. Sorry, Craig. It's 2 out of 10 for you.
But Paul Rudkin says, Craig is the greatest. Strictly needs his technical eye. I give him a 10.
There we are. Honesty is always the key. So, no, I mean, it's great to have you all here because there's such a vast array of knowledge here. But, Ben, we just want to talk to you about Thomas Hitzlsperger, who's just come out. He's the most high-profile footballer to have come out and said that he's gay. This all came out yesterday. I mean, you're heavily involved in your anti-bullying foundation. So do you think, I mean, it was obviously right for him to do it, but quite a big deal.
I think it's important not to live a lie, and I think congratulate him for coming out. Especially, it's a bit frustrating sometimes to see them come out post-sport. You know, take, for instance, with Tom Daly coming out in the height of his career.
Right in one.
Yeah, it can have a big impact, a big, great role model. But, you know, nevertheless, it's still, you know, it's still someone to say, you know, I've come out. And he has some regret. I mean, what I read up on it, his regret not coming out. But, you know, you have two aspects of it. You have a singleton sport and you have a team sport. And he couldn't feel that he could come out in a team sport. So there's still a lot of work to be done there. But education's key, and educating our next generation.
Brilliant. Well, we're looking forward very much to seeing you all dance in a second.
It's nearly time.
But first, Miranda, they've been brilliant films. Now, remember, keep sending in your family photos to the usual address. If you want to be part of our one-show family mosaic, there's still time, isn't there?
Yes, now. It's time to get dancing. Would the 14 stars of the Strictly Tour 2014 please take to the floor for the Viennese Waltz?
And while they do that, we'll have a Viennese Waltz.
Like the mountains in springtime, like a walk in the rain, like a storm in the desert, like the sleepy blue ocean. You fill up my senses, come fill me.
Strictly Tour.
Bring it on.
Nobody messed up, Craig.
I know, I'm amazed, absolutely amazed. Aren't they fantastic?
Yeah,
we've trained them
brilliant.
Well.
Brilliant, so good. Oh. Thanks very much to Craig, of course, and the Strictly stars. Good luck on tour.
Good
tickets
luck, everybody.
Are on sale now. Yeah. Join us tomorrow when Vic and Bob will be here with Chris and I.
Now, from one big Saturday night show to another, the new series of The Voice starts this weekend, and as a bit of a teaser, we're going to leave you with a full performance from all of the coaches.
See you tomorrow.
Bye-bye.